it has potential to be a very significant discovery for genetic engineering. Just imagine how important it would be if it turns out that we can switch off any virus disease by switching off the genetics of that virus disease. It's a very exciting possibility.
In 1987, researchers from CSIRO were investigating how some plants protect themselves from virus disease. They came across a molecule of genetic material with odd but very exciting behavior. The molecule was able to break itself into smaller fragments by folding back and cutting itself.
The implications for that molecule being able to fold back on itself were quite profound. Those design rules that that molecule used to fold back on itself and break itself apart could be adapted to virtually any genetic molecule, so that you could build a new molecule which would bind to a genetic molecule and break it to pieces. You could therefore switch off any gene potentially using this mechanism.
So the idea of the gene shears was born. But CSIRO knew it did not have the field to itself. Scientists overseas were pursuing similar lines of research.
It was a very exciting time. We weren't able to say anything to anyone, but the excitement in the lab was quite dramatic.
Every plant or animal carries genes that determine how it develops and grows, how it looks and how it responds to its environment. There are about 100,000 genes in each living cell. Genes carry coded instructions for producing proteins, the building blocks of life. The instructions are picked up by molecules known as messenger RNAs and carried to the part of the cell that produces proteins. Gene shears are molecules created in the laboratory. They can be designed to seek and destroy a specific messenger RNA and therefore inactivate any unwanted or harmful gene.
So what we did was to set about testing this to see whether it worked in a test tube. So we designed new molecules and had them built on a DNA synthesizing machine and tested those new molecules, ones that had never before been seen in nature, and yes, they did work according to those design rules.
Now another exciting application emerged. The gene shears could be used to make plants resistant to virus disease. Because viruses work like genes, they can also be inactivated by gene shears. By posing as the messenger RNA from a gene, the virus replicates itself in the cells of the host, causing disease and even death. Antivirus gene shears can prevent disease by destroying an invading virus before it can multiply. This technology will be exploited to make existing crops resistant to common virus diseases. By switching off unwanted genes in plants, new crops could be created with improved nutritional content. Gene shears could also solve a virus problem that costs cheesemakers millions of dollars every year. The bacteria and yeasts used in cheesemaking are vulnerable to attack by viruses. Gene shears could make them resistant.
It was probably the most theoretical piece of research that we were doing in the laboratory, yet it has the most potential in that the benefits that could accrue from it may be in the tens or hundreds of millions of dollars.